Hello, welcome back to the Gonzo Ewok channel. So once again, I find myself in the position that I have to sort out the planets and systems that I've just taken over. I'm going to need lots of defensive armies on these ones because there's going to be rebellions otherwise. There's lots of unrest. I'm going to divvy them up into sectors. So I'll add that Hathgun planet onto this existing sector. It should be the Hathgun sector. Must be the Hypno one, yeah. I'll add that in there. Over here, we're going to have to create a new sector. Okay, we're going to need to make sure that we're fully stocked with defensive armies to quell any prospect of rebellion. Because these people aren't going to be happy to have been taken over and, in some cases, enslaved. Several of them will be in shackles. I'm building assault armies. That's just crazy. Click, 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 click. Sorry about the clicking. It'll be over soon. Divvy that into a sector as well. Oh, that should be everything. And yeah, I'm back in the positive on everything, which is good. Next thing is get my armies back to my space. Armies and navies. I'm prepped for the next battle. Repaired as well. gonna switch the rally points over as well. So now people are gonna rally to Carillion Armada rather than the Second Fleet. Second Fleet doesn't have a Blooming Admiral. That's ridiculous. Recruit an Admiral. As soon as they're out of Sildari space, I will be declaring war again. I'm going to hit them with a two-pronged attack. Okay, we've discovered salt. Drop that cruiser over the Sildari planet. Sole reason I'm doing that is to prevent them from building any ships during the upcoming war. Just ignore that little anomaly patch of space. Don't have to worry about fighting there, right? And push both my navies and armies up the one front in a united two-pronged assault. Stop taking shortcuts to enemy space. Just go the long way around. More or less ready to go. Just get that last bit of repair done. Guys, no, oh, this must be a change with the latest patch. So I specifically declared war on one that a power that I knew would be thrown out. Damn it, we're forced into a peace treaty for another 9 years. Oh, that's so painful. That's so painful and frustrating that I have to make peace with these guys. Is there nothing I can do? I guess not. That's annoying. That is annoying. I thought I was being clever. Right, so we're just going to have to speed things up. Nothing I can do. I wonder if it's because I knocked the other one out. Oh, because I've done that before. Let's do some ship upgrades. Get them more advanced weapons on. Oh, I've got more advanced type of drives as well. Let's make sure we've got them installed on the other two then. Thank you. isn't how I intended to spend this part of the game. I thought it was just going to be steamrolling my way to victory at this point. And I'm having to wait. I'm not very patient. Civic. So I'm currently producing loads of extra minerals. I could have a police day and get that unrest down. That could be blooming useful. Increase my border range. Don't really need to. Yeah, we'll adopt a police state. And get that unrest down. And we can upgrade that to an Empire Capital Complex. Construction complete. System survey complete. System survey complete. Construction complete.
System survey complete. Construction complete.
I suppose this downtime has kind of forced me to develop my planets a bit, even if it's not how I would have spent my time. But it's good to have a robust economy. It'll help in the days to come. So I can't be too miffed. After all, we are marching towards the end. It's allowed me to get a lot of things in order.
Research complete. Construction complete. Construction complete. Construction complete. Construction complete. Construction complete. Anomaly found. Construction complete. System survey complete. Construction complete. Construction complete. Construction complete.
Two more years. Patiently waiting to destroy my enemies. July 23 or 4. It's interesting that at the moment they've got exactly the same fleet strength.
Research complete. Construction complete. System survey complete. Construction complete.
Nearly good to go. Is this what it's come to? Just waiting for the clock to tick down. We are way past the 20 minute mark. We are 6 minutes past the 20 minute mark. So what I'll do is I will take it to the date in question and declare war. So I want everything that the Sildari have. Score. Frustrating. What to do? Could I take the Agarians out? I can. So let's do it properly. Let's declare war against the Agarians. Take everything they've got. System. So that'll take the Agarians out of the game, and by taking one planet away from the Sildari, that should mean I can destroy them entirely in the next war, which will be the final war. And the reason I wanted to do that is because I didn't want to go through an episode where I wasn't at war. So that's the next episode. Next episode is going to be fighting again with the Sildari and the Agarians, but with the aim of entirely taking over the Agarian High Kingdom. Come back and join me for that. Thank you very much for watching. I've been Ewok. Goodbye.